There's the camera. Hello. Huh? I'm a Nevada girl, you know.
Are you really?
Fourth generation.
Where were you born?
Reno.
Ooh. You just snorked her.
Name the most relaxing thing you do.
Make love.
What a sweetheart you are. A position on a baseball team.
Pitcher.
A chocolate food.
So today I wanted to check out an American game show called Family Feud. We had a version of it on Irish television that came over from the UK called Family Fortunes, but I believe this show has been running since the 1970s on American television, and it's been through a number of guises. I remember when I was a kid and I used to watch Family Fortunes and think, could my family go on it? But I actually don't think there's a world where my family would go on Family Fortunes, but my mom would kill with the answers. I remember the funniest answers were always the best ones, things that people said unexpectedly or when you were caught off guard. So today I'm going to be checking out a celebrity special from the days gone by, the days of yore. Before getting into the video, do be sure to like, share, comment, and subscribe. A lot of you guys say you still get the curse even though you subscribe, but did you also like, share, and comment? If you don't, an unfortunate thing may befall you, and that thing may be that the next time you go into a room, you're gonna forget why you went in there, and then you're gonna leave and remember, and then go back in and forget again. I don't want that to happen to you, so like, share, comment, subscribe.
Original cast of Gilligan's Island, Batman, Hawaiian Eye, and
What's
Hawaiian Eye? Space. Introducing for today's feud, the Gilligan's Island family.
I've heard of Gilligan's Island, but I've never seen it.
Jim Backus.
And I don't
Natalie
know
Schaefer,
any of these people.
Russell Johnson. Don Wells. Reunited again.
They look
ready
great, though.
For action. Competing against the Batman family. Adam West.
Oh, Adam West. Lee, yes, I know Adam West. I know her face.
Trey. Bert Ward. And Vincent Price. As they are today. On your mark. Let's play the Family Feud.
It's exactly the same setup as the British version of the show. Like, exactly the same. I love the vintage writing, though. It's really cute.
We're so happy to be here again. Thank you. Now, so far, Gilligan's Island, they've been playing for the Motion Picture and TV Fund.
Won
$5,503.
Is he going to introduce himself? Is this the first host
and
of the show?
Batman are playing for World Vision. That helps children. $5,520. That's a good new sum. They're going to fight it out today, and then they will go into the finals tomorrow. And tomorrow is a $10,000 day that we play. All for charity.
Oh, that's great. No, that's how they do the celebrity shows. Today, too. I like his hat.
Yeah, I gotta tell you, it's a thrill for me to see you all. You played so well, you won the money when
Isn't
you got
out there. Isn't that exciting? Really, we are. Yeah. Gilligan's Island, bless their hearts, they're wonderful people.
We'll all have a little party at the Lobster Barrel a little later.
Hey,
let's meet them all. I know them and love them, but let's meet them.
Yes, certainly. Ladies and gentlemen, and Dickie, of course.
Yeah.
Our wondrous friend and Mr. Howell on the island, Jim Backus.
Hey.
Mr. Russell Johnson.
Welcome, Russell.
And certainly, again, it goes without saying, last but not least, our lovely Dawn Wells. Mary.
Oh, she's a very pretty lady. Totally different look than it is now, but very
Thank
beautiful.
You for being here.
Thank you.
You seem to be having
we
a good time.
We are having a lovely time. And I appreciate
it. I cried all the way through those introductions because Jim said he wanted a stunt check for doing the show.
No,
coming down the stairs.
Well, this is my first game show, and I'm adoring it.
I really thank you, because I know...
Oh, she's fabulous.
Hold them up. I just love them. They're so elegant. Look. I love them.
Oh, I love that. I wish I hope to be like that one
day. I'm interested in you.
I'm sort of a rarity.
Thank you.
But the professor.
Hi, Richard.
How are you?
I'm well, thank you.
Here's the gambler of the group.
Here's the gambler. Hello. I'm a Nevada girl, you know.
Are you really?
Fourth generation.
Where were you born?
Reno.
Ooh. He just snogged her! Oh my god! On the mouth! Oh my god! It was a different time.
You know, the watch demo was worth $100. I could make the difference.
Cooties.
We'll play in the big game. But you've done very well until now.
We don't need it.
We gamblers don't need it.
That's right.
Exactly. Look at them.
Look at
Swan.
Look at
my god.
Definitely.
Two gooders.
Adam West, like, he's definitely the best known out of everybody. The name that has, as far as I know, that has
lasted.
We had a little taste of victory the
you
other
did,
time.
That's
yes, it felt so
okay, so this
good.
Is their
that's
second time good. Playing. Oh, so these are, like, obviously semifinals.
It's better than fighting crime, isn't
it?
Are by right, one of the worst villainesses ever to walk in Gotham City. Also, Miss America one time, our friend Leanne Merriweather.
Very sexy role.
Right next to Leanne, the young lady who played Batgirl so well. And
Batgirl,
also humor on the set, Yvonne Craig.
Never really caught on, did it? Batgirl. Alicia Silverstone.
The tougher half
roasted.
Of the crime-fighting duo.
Would she play Batgirl?
Robin, Burt Ward.
Oh! You always think of Robin as really young. He does not look really young.
And Mr. Vincent Price.
Is he a villain?
Egghead.
One of the most horrible, evil people ever.
No, don't know Egghead.
I see.
You don't need to see that in television. You can meet those people at home. That's my love.
I have one kiss. One kiss. That's from my mother. This is from Kyle. And that's from Leslie. And this is from me.
You got anything there?
Well, she took control of the situation, so good for her.
I was just wondering if it was an aunt in Omaha.
Sorry, darling,
not
at all.
I don't know. I didn't go for Guadalajara.
I think she's covered all the legal ground on television.
The women are a little like, am I
wonder
wrong?
If we could discuss other areas a little later. I love her leg.
What was that?
Friend of the Kleiners in Montreal.
There it is. Black quad.
Hold it.
Yep.
Yay!
What's that?
Wait a minute. I got the black one.
There you go. You both got $100 now.
Ah, that's nice. That's nice.
Let's play it again. Let's go. 100 people survey. Top 5 answers on the board. You got to try and get the
okay,
most popular
go.
Answer.
Let's go.
Here's the question. Name something people buy before boarding a plane.
Tickets.
A ticket.
A ticket. Yes, sir. Hey. 2 answers will beat that, huh?
Gravamen.
Gravamen.
What did he say?
There you go. You got control.
I don't know what that was.
What do you want to do? Play. Richard will play.
We're going to play. All right. So, Chicago elections. He thought that was close enough to number one.
Okay.
Blaine, what do we buy before
right.
we book that?
Luggage.
Oh.
Luggage, yeah, that's
luggage.
A good answer.
No.
Oh.
No, I never, ever get to the airport and start looking for luggage because you've got all the stuff under your arm going through security.
I mean...
And they laugh at your jockey shorts.
You go.
People buy before boarding a plane.
Extra insurance.
Huh, yeah.
Oh, that's a good one.
Non-schedule airline.
Ryanair always trying to extra. Oh, good one! Yay, well done! Good job. Top answer.
Well, there's not too many left, but I'm going to try souvenirs.
Souvenir?
Yes.
Souvenir! Oh, luckily, we've come to the great news.
What else?
You can help
water?
Us
oh, I got it.
What is it?
Something to read.
Oh, that's a good one. Yeah, before technology. That's
not
a great
just
one.
Another
yep.
pretty face.
No, you're so right.
Something to read. You know it's there.
There it is.
Nice.
What people buy before boarding a plane?
Snack?
A toy. The kids
yeah.
Oh, I see.
It's a great answer.
A toy. Oh, Skipper! Skipper!
Okay. So then he goes over to the other phone.
Yeah, we'd be running around right now if he were the skipper. Oh, there's $90 up there. One answer, unrevealed.
Candy or gum?
Okay,
that's a good one. Good one. Yeah. Good one.
Oh, that's good. That's good. A lot of people do that, and I think that's a goodie. And if it's there, you get the $90. If not, Adam gets it. Get it?
Nice. Good job. Good job.
Really? Is that your answer? If Jim shot
so they stole. That's what we called it when I was a kid.
Jim, being so wealthy, doesn't even have to come over here. We have put a buzzer there. And you're being so pretty,
so
we've given
wonderful.
You a buzzer.
I love it. Thank you, Jim.
Thank you,
I shall read carefully. Here we go.
Maybe he's a mobility
100
issue.
People survey, top 7 answers on the board. Here's the question. Name the most relaxing thing you do.
Read.
Read.
TV. Watch TV.
Watch television. Uncle Jim.
Very different back in the 70s than the answers are now.
Repeat that, Uncle Jim. Name the most relaxing
was this the
80s? Thing you do.
Make love.
What a sweetheart you are.
Oh! Well, that's unexpected. Could be up there. He's devil.
Even if it's not there, I'm going to chip in a couple of dollars myself, Jim. Make love! It's there!
Aw, I like how they called it making love. That's nice.
Most relaxing thing you do?
Take a hot bath.
Oh, good answer, good answer.
You got it.
Nice. Bathe. Nice.
I say listening to relaxing music.
Hearing music.
Yeah.
Yes, sir. Well, you did
all right. For me, the most relaxing thing is gardening.
You like that?
Oh,
yeah.
That's a good love answer. That.
Gardening! No.
It's not common, though, is it?
You do. You like to potter around there. Okay. Adam?
Sleeping.
Sleeping?
That is relaxing. It's the ultimate relaxing. Yeah. Okay. Okay. Kind of a trick answer, in a way.
No,
I mean, you're optimum
this?
Relaxed.
Reading Vincent Price's books.
Oh, yeah, reading.
Just reading books.
That's great. That's a great way to relax. Read.
That's got to be it. Yeah, there you go. 100%.
How about get a massage?
Oh, yeah. Ah, good answer.
Love it. Massage. No?
The most relaxing thing.
Well, it does. It's a great way to relax.
Go for a walk in the park.
Walk, yeah. Cuddle a pet.
Walk in the park.
Walk your dog.
Ready, $5. You can talk up. I'm coming over to you. Yell the answers out if you wish. What have you come up with?
Strong drink.
Have a drink.
Have a drink.
Make
that's
a good
one. That's a good one.
Strong drink gets you all the money. If not a very even game, because Adam and the gang will get the $85. Drink!
Oh, what is it then? What's the top answer? Sunbathe. Oh, we don't
then
do that now.
Then make love.
SPF, baby.
And then come
be pale,
in from the
like
park.
Your girl.
And we'll be back right after this. Game, $90, Gilligan's 85, Batman, Yvonne, we sample it. Wish each other luck.
Yes.
Always like to see good sports person. 100 people surveyed,
sportsman.
Top 5 answers on the board. Here's the question. Name something you bring into the bedroom for a day when you're sick in bed.
Lemsip or 7-Up or whatever.
Pill.
The American equivalent is.
A book. A book. You're doing very well for the reading.
Hot tea?
Now, just talk it over. Are you going to play
hot
or
water
pass?
Bottle?
You going to play?
Tissues?
Oh, okay. Oh, something you bring into the bedroom for a day when you're sick in bed, Russell.
The telly.
Yeah, sure. Telly.
That's a good one. Yeah.
Yeah. Good. What would you say, Robert?
Okay, Claire, can you do it?
Tray of food?
Tray of food?
Yeah.
I don't know. Okay, that's an interesting thing, because I remember that from when I used to watch Family Fortunes, because that was the guy's accent, that sometimes they would give somebody the... Oh, Chewie's gone. Sometimes they would give people the benefit of the answer, even though it wasn't quite the answer. And then other times they'd be really mean with it. Like, they wouldn't give somebody the answer, even though that's, like, clearly what they were trying to say. I guess maybe because this one was for charity, it's, like, fair enough. They were kind of just giving people, like, the closest.
A bed tray?
Yeah.
A bed tray.
A bench tray.
What do you think, Jim?
I think a radio for soothing music.
Gotcha.
Radio.
Good,
Jim.
Radio?
Yeah.
No, out there. Sweet now.
Cards for solitaire.
Okay.
Good. Hey, that's
well, you can't concentrate that much when you're sick.
Playing cards? No. $89. Come on down here.
Okay.
Roll them. What do you say?
Kleenex.
Kleenex?
Oh, I love how you call it the brand name rather than just tissues. Let's see if my answers are up there. No, I didn't have that one. That's
particularly if you have a broken ankle.
Very particular.
It's always useful. What, five?
Two?
Telephone. 179, playing 85.
Really?
Let's go.
Those are very odd answers.
Dollar values are double. Here's the question. Name an actor or actress who is also a political activist.
Everyone these days.
Jane Fonda. Jane Fonda.
Back then, oh, I couldn't tell you.
I like Russell.
Elvis?
I'd be 4 minutes early if they were all like that.
Oh, gosh.
Got 3 seconds.
How about Paul Newman?
Paul Newman.
Good answer. Yes, sir.
Jennifer,
what would you say?
3 seconds.
I can't.
All right.
I can't do it.
Oh, don't worry. Jim, an actor or an actress who is also a political activist. Ronald Reagan.
That's a great answer.
God bless him. Ronald Reagan.
Oh, very good.
Ed Asner.
It is.
Okay. Very good, Alan. Very good.
You got it, and you'll play for $10,000. Ed Asner?
Well done. Okay, so they're going to play Double Money now, it's called in the UK. What's it called in America?
Like, this is the day before the end of our second week. That was the toughest. That was the toughest question, truly. That was not an easy question. And they all applauded you, too. That was a great, well done.
Good sports personship.
At 85, that we're going to add to your score here. Will you stay in Rudamont for me? All righty. Who's going to play? Two people. Go. Playing for the Rudamont.
More kissing. Jesus. More kissing! So much kissing.
Please.
So many germs.
Name a foreign country that sex symbols come from.
Italy.
Brazil.
An animal that big game hunters hunt.
Deer.
Bears.
A fabric evening gowns are made of.
Chiffon.
Silk.
A position on a baseball team.
Pitcher.
A chocolate food.
Pitcher.
Hot fudge sundae.
Turn around.
Brownie. I got the baseball one really wrong. I can't think of any catcher.
Italia.
Yeah.
That's a good answer. That could be a Tom answer.
There. Survey. Yeah. It makes Bambi an endangered species. Fabric evening gowns are made of chiffon, which is margarine. Survey. Position on a baseball team. Pitchers. Survey said.
That's a good one. That could be top answer. Very, very much could be.
Chocolate sundaes, as I said. Two. That's exactly what you're supposed to do. Meet them halfway. Looking for Russell?
Shall we do it?
Yes, sir. Let's
do it. Please remind everyone the answers Dawn gave.
I love that they're so dressed up. I never noticed that before.
Name a foreign country that sex symbols come from.
France.
An animal the big game hunters hunt.
Tigers.
A fabric evening gowns are made of.
Silk.
A position on a baseball team.
First base.
A chocolate food.
Oh, yeah.
Cake. Turn around.
He did great. He did great.
Much better with the hands.
Did he get them all? Maybe.
Much quicker, though. Much quicker.
First base. Why didn't they think of that? Is that not just a spot on the field?
This time he just was cool, calm, and collected. A foreign country sex symbols come from? France, you said. It was number one. Seriously?
Could be the top answer.
An animal, big game, hunter's hunt. Lion was number one. You said a tiger. Survey said. Nine.
It's a bit exotic.
Fabric evening gowns are made of. You said silk. It was number one. Survey said.
Yeah, that's a tough
one. Position on a baseball team. Pitcher was number one. You said first base. We need 19 points for $5,000. Survey said. 10.
I don't know if that's a
chocolate
position.
Chocolate food. You said let them eat cake. 9 points. Survey said let them eat cake.
Nice. Wow. Oh, they don't go through the top answers on the American show? On the American show, they have to... Or on the English show, they have to get points. And they also had to get the top answer. So they get points for the money. Fun little difference. On the British show, you could get the top answers and win a car in addition to the money. What? No car, America? But that was really interesting. I love that game. Did you know that if you can pitch a really, really good game show, you can make a lot of money? Because game shows are one of the most profitable things to sell internationally on a television basis. Speaking of families, we have a couple of very special shout-outs today for Mother's Day. Aww. Jason Moyer says, although his mother has been gone for 6 years, he still thinks of her often and misses her dearly. He says, this shout out is for those of us whose mothers have passed on. Take comfort in knowing she will always be with you. As Rudyard Kipling said, God could not be everywhere and therefore he made mothers. And on a similar vein, we have Eric, aka the Stories Telling Stories channel, who wants to dedicate his shout out to his mom. Next month, they will be having a celebration of her life. And he says, we only have one mom and one chance to share time with her. She's worth your time. After all, she used her time to bring you up. Thank you so much, Eric. And that's it for today. See you guys on the other side. Bye. I'll go to sneeze. I really need to sneeze. Like a lot. Okay, I really need to sneeze. But I'm gonna just. No, I'm not. I really need to chew.